Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Pullein. This week I want to talk to you about labels and to explain to you why I took the decision this week to completely stop using labels. Yes, you heard me right. I've stopped using labels. Now, for those of you who don't know the history of the productivity world, labels originated from something called contexts from David Allen's book, Getting Things Done. Now, essentially what a context is a person, a place, or a tool that you need in order to complete a task. So for example, if you have a colleague that you work closely with, you would create a label for that person. And then whenever you are with that person, you could just tap that label and the list of tasks required that you wanted to talk to them about or ask them to do would come up in that list. Likewise, if you have a number of telephone calls to make each day, then you could have a label which you use with calls and all the list of calls for that day would come up. Now, for those of you who make a lot of calls per day, those of you who have to do a lot of follow-ups per day, and those of you who work with a specific number of people closely, then sure, labels can be very, very useful. And if that's the case, I wouldn't recommend you stop using them. But for somebody like me who doesn't have any employees, I just have clients that I work with, I found that I really didn't need labels. I don't have very many calls to make each week, and calls that I do have are scheduled through my calendar. Also, I don't really need to use specific tools to do my work. Regularly, I start my blog post, for example, while sitting on a bus or in the subway train. I use it on my phone. When I get back home, I can open up my laptop and I can continue writing the blog post. So I don't need a specific tool to write a blog post. Now, of course, to make these videos, I do need to be in a certain place, my little studio, and have my camera equipment with me. But again, that's not really something I need to worry about because I have that scheduled in my calendar. You know, Friday afternoons, I do my videos and that's essentially where I'm going to be in my studio. My equipment is there. So again, I realized that what was happening was I was just adding labels because of it was something I'd always done. But when I stopped and asked myself the question, do I get any value from these labels? Well, the answer was, no, I don't. I'm not really using them. So essentially, I removed them and I've been finding that when it's processing my inbox at the end of the day, it's really, really fast because I don't have to think about labels. I really only have to think about where does this go, i.e. what project does this go into? And when, or if I really need to add a when, a date, to doing it. Now, I still use flags. Flags are a really big part of my day. Flagging my two objectives with the red flag, that's P1, and flagging my morning tasks with the orange flag, and flagging my afternoon tags with the blue flag. Yep, that's really important for me because that helps me to organize my day. But labels, I just found were not useful for me. But that's going to say, and I will repeat this, that doesn't necessarily mean that labels are not going to be useful for you. What I would suggest you do, though, is have a look over the weekend or over next week at your labels and just see if any of them are just superfluous for your needs. Of course, some of you, as I say, will need calls, follow-ups, and maybe you need to do certain work in a certain office, in which case, of course, if you're working between two places, it could be useful to have a label for each of those places. But really, I guess most of you these days, if you are really honest with yourselves, would probably find that you no longer really need that many labels because your phone can do a lot of the work that you've always been able to do. So hopefully that's been giving you something to think about, something to really help simplify your system. I don't know if you're following my channel, you know that my theme for 2020 is simplification and minimalization. And this is just one of those little things that cropped up as I was reviewing my whole system. And I thought, yep, labels can go. Don't worry, I don't anticipate losing my projects, but who knows, maybe I will lose my areas of focus. But that might be for a future episode. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now, have I got something special to tell you about? the Time and Life Mastery version 3 course has launched. Now, this course is transformative. It will transform your life. If you find that your life is drifting from one day to the next and that you feel that you're not actually achieving your goals, then this course is going to show you how to change that. It's going to show you how to identify what is truly important to you. It's going to show you how to find what it is you want out of life and then show you the steps that you need to take in order to get there. This course is amazing. The feedback I've got from versions 1 and version 2 have just been tremendous. It has helped so many people, and I want this opportunity to tell you that it can do the same for you. I hope you will take a look at the course, have a go, take the course, and start transforming your life today. This course will do that for you. Take a look, get yourself enrolled, and hopefully I'll see you in the course.